I'm sorry for the change of timing. Before we start, I would like to introduce the officers that are present here from the three services. We have Major General Surinder Singh Mahal from the Army.
Good evening.
We have Rear Admiral Dalbir Singh Gujral from the Navy. And we have Air Vice Marshal RGK Kapoor from Indian Air Force. I'll be requesting the service representatives to present a statement, following which we will also be taking few questions. And in the end, I will request the Air Force to present you all with some evidence. May I now request AVM Kapoor to kindly give his statement.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On 27th February 2019, at around 1000 hours, Indian Air Force radars detected a large package of Pakistan Air Force aircraft heading towards the Indian territory, towards General Area Jangar. They breached the Indian airspace west of Rajouri in the Sundarbani area. The ingressing aircraft were observed to be at various levels. IAF fighters, including MiG-21 Bison, Sukhoi 30 MKI and Mirage 2000, were tasked to intercept the intruding Pakistan Air Force aircraft. The Pakistan Air Force aircraft attempting to target our military installations were intercepted by the IAF fighter aircraft, which foiled their attack. Although PAF bombs have fallen in the Indian Army formation compounds, however, they were unable to cause any damage to our military installations. In the aerial combat that ensued, one F-16 of Pakistan Air Force was shot down by an IAF MiG-21 Bison aircraft. The F-16 crashed and fell across the line of control in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. The IAF lost one MiG-21 in the aerial engagement, and though the pilot ejected safely, his parachute drifted into the Pakistan-occupied JNK, where he was taken into custody by the Pakistan Army. There have been many factually incorrect statements that have been made by Pakistan. The first blatant disinformation was that two IAF aircraft were shot down by Pakistan and three pilots of Indian Air Force were down. This figure was later revised downwards to two IAF aircraft and two pilots. The fact, however, is that Indian Army units had reported sighting two parachutes falling in POJNK, which were of two F-16 pilots, the aircraft which was shot down by the MiG-21. Pakistan later in the evening changed its statement to say that one Indian pilot was in their custody. Therefore, it was only by late evening that Pakistan accepted the fact. Secondly, Pakistan claimed that they intentionally dropped weapons in open space where there was no human presence or military posts. The fact is that Pakistan Air Force aircraft targeted military installations. However, they were intercepted by IAF fighter aircraft, which thwarted their plans. Although PAF bombs have fallen in Indian Army formation compounds, however, they were unable to cause any significant damage to our military installations due to a swift IAF response. Pakistan also stated that no F-16s were used in the operation. and no Pakistani plane was downed by Indian Air Force. There is enough evidence to show that F-16s were used in this mission through the electronic signatures, and thereafter the Pakistan is trying to hide this fact. Also, parts of AMRAAM, air-to-air missile, which is carried only on the Pakistan F-16s, was recovered east of Rajouri within the Indian territory. Therefore, the fact remains that one F-16 of PAF was shot down by IAF MiG-21 Bison. IAF remains ever vigilant, ready, and committed to take on any eventuality. IAF has also learned that Pakistan has announced that Wing Commander Abhinandan will be returned to India tomorrow. IAF is happy and looks forward to return of Wing Commander Abhinandan. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Major General Bahal to kindly give the Army statement.
Jayant, and good evening to everyone. In response to the counter terrorist strike by the Indian Air Force, Pakistan Army first resorted to unprovoked ceasefire violations, as you are aware, in Sundarbani, Bimber Gali, Naushera and Krishna Ghati sectors on 26th February, with effect from 5 o'clock in the evening and again during the night. This was responded to by the Indian Army in a befitting and appropriate manner. As my Air Force counterpart has elaborated, on 27th February 19, the Pakistan Air Force attempted to target our military establishments in JNK. Specifically, they targeted a brigade headquarters, a battalion headquarters, our defenses, and a logistic installation. However, given the high level of preparedness along the line of control and the immediate and punitive response given by our own forces, the Pakistan Air Force's designs were foiled. We continue to maintain strict vigil along both the line of control and the IB sector. Our ground-based air defense weapon systems have been put on a high alert all along the line of control and also in some parts of the IB. Our mechanized forces have also been placed on standby. I wish to assure the nation that we are fully prepared and in a heightened state of readiness to respond to any provocation by Pakistan. Despite the turn of events, as you all are aware, the Indian Army is committed to maintaining peace and stability in the region and will continue to act against agencies who harbor inimical designs against India and the citizens of our country. Jayant.
Thank you, sir. Admiral Gujral, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Indian Navy is deployed in a high state of readiness and remains poised in all three dimensions, on surface, undersea, and in air, to deter, prevent, and defeat any misadventure by Pakistan in the maritime domain. I can assure you of a resolute, swift, and strong response by the Navy when needed. We stand as one with the Army and Air Force to ensure the safety and security of our nation and our citizens. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Before we present the evidence in front of you, we would now like to take few questions. Snesh.
Sir, the Pakistan Air Force targeted Indian military establishments. Would we consider it as an act of war by Pakistan Because when we carried out these strikes, we targeted non-military installations. They specifically targeted our military installations.
So, there is no doubt that Pakistan has attempted to target our military installations. We responded swiftly, and because of which their designs to deliver their bomb load at the intended target was thwarted. And that is a task of the Air Force, which it did swiftly and responsibly.
Sir. Rajiv Ranjan.
Sir, मेरा सवाल सर आपसे है आर्मी से.
Okay.
जिस तरह के कार्रवाई हुई है जैस के टेररिस्ट कैंप के कार्रवाई हुई उसके बाद पाकिस्तान ने जिस हरकत की है लगातार सीज़फ़ायर का वायलेशन पाकिस्तान कर रहा है तो सीमा पर क्या माने कि तनाव पहले की तरह बरकरार है या बढ़ गया है लेवल सेना उसको कैसे जवाब दे रही है.
देखिए हमारा लड़ाई जो है काउंटर टेररिज्म हमारा लड़ाई जो है टेररिज्म के साथ है तो जब तक पाकिस्तान जो है इसको इस तरह से सपोर्ट करता रहेगा हम उनके जितने भी टेररिस्ट कैंप और जितने भी उसके ट्रेनिंग एरियाज हैं उनको हम टारगेट करने के लिए तैयार हैं. तो हालांकि 14 फरवरी के बाद सीज फायर वायलेशंस काफ़ी बढ़ गई है और पिछले दो दिनों में कम से कम 35 सीज फायर वायलेशंस हुए हैं लेकिन हम जो है उसका उसी हूबहू उसी प्रकार से उसका जवाब दे रहे हैं.
Sir, this is Manas from PTI. Pakistan has been pressing for de-escalation. What is the assessment from the Indian military brass? I mean, what is the real situation actually? What is your assessment? Is it going to escalate? Is the situation going to escalate? Or you expect that in fact the situation is going to normalize?
As we said, that you know your question, as we said, that he has targeted our military installations. As I mentioned, he's targeted military targets. And therefore, the escalation has actually been done by him. So we are prepared, as I told you, we are ready. If he provokes us any further, we are prepared for any contingency that is like is given.
Sir. Poonam Pandey. Sir. Poonam Pandey, please.
Sir, aapne bola ki ceasefire violation badh gaya hai aur abhi bhi wahan terrorist camp hai. तो हम मतलब मिलिट्री क्या उम्मीद कर रही है क्या पाकिस्तान उन पर कार्रवाई करेगा क्योंकि जिस तरीके से इमरान खान लगातार अमन की बात कर रहे हैं उनका ISPR लगातार अमन की बात कर रहा है तो हम क्या उम्मीद कर रहे हैं.
This question is out of the purview of this press conference. Government of India is taking note of this and the answer will be given. Ajit Dubey, please, I'll come to you, please. Ajit Dubey.
You want to ask the FO?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Sir, my question is that on 26th February, our Mirages crossed over the line of control, entered Pakistani airspace and carried out a major operation against the Jaish camp in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province. Can you tell us what has been the damage assessment to that camp and there are talks that there were around 300 terrorists in that camp. Can we give any numbers, any approximate numbers of the terrorists who have been killed there?
There is fairly credible evidence with us which proves that there was damage to the camps. The weapons hit the intended target and they caused the damage that was intended. However, it will be premature to say that what is the number of casualties we have been able to inflict on those camps and what is the number of deaths.
But has the camp been fully destroyed, sir?
Whatever we intended to destroy, we have got the effect that we desired.
Thank you. Krishna Mohan.
Chalo, main hoon, sir.
Yeah.
Aaj ke pure development ke baad.
So you can come here, sir.
Ab, you can look in front of you. Jo lagataar pichle kuch dinon se tension tha, LOC par, aur lagataar ceasefire violation ho rahi thi, speculation the pure desh mein. आज के डेवलपमेंट पर क्या आपको लगता है कम होगा और वैली में टेररिस्ट जो रिलेटेड इंसिडेंट्स हैं इनमें क्या आपको लगता है कि और तेजी आएगी या वो कम होगी.
ये जवाब तो आप पाकिस्तान से पूछिए क्योंकि अभी भी जो है सीज फायर वायलेशंस एज वी स्पीक जारी है तो ये पाकिस्तान के ऊपर है कि वो क्या चाहते हैं.
मंजीत
सर, मेरा सवाल आपसे है. अपनी जो बालाकोट में जो हमने मिराज से जो आतंकी अड्डों को निशाना बनाया उसको लेकर और जो F-16 हमने गिराया दोनों घटनाओं को लेकर पाकिस्तान ने लगातार कहा कि भारत ने ऐसा कोई हमला नहीं किया, ऐसा कोई अटैक नहीं किया, उसके सबूत नहीं है। उनके कुछ पे लोड ऐसे इलाकों में गिरे जहां पर कोई इंस्टॉलेशन नहीं थे। तो पाकिस्तान के दावे को झूठा साबित करने के लिए, अपनी बात को हम स्थापित करने के लिए, हम किस तरह से चीज़ों को आगे रखेंगे, उसके लिए क्या क्या हम सबूत दिखाना चाहेंगे पाकिस्तान को?
What you are going to see today as a piece of evidence, which is a part of a AMRAAM air-to-air missile. This is a beyond visual range air-to-air missile, जो कि F-16 पाकिस्तान में सिर्फ एक जहाज है F-16, जो कि AMRAAM मिसाइल लेके उड़ सकता है, और कोई भी उनके पास जहाज नहीं है जिस पे AMRAAM मिसाइल लगाई जा सके। ये कि वो उस मिसाइल के टुकड़े राजौरी के ईस्ट में इंडियन टेरिटरी में पाए गए हैं, इसका मतलब है कि उन्होंने F-16 का यूज किया है। दूसरा, एयरफोर्स के पास काफी तरह से हम पता कर सकते हैं कि कौन सा जहाज उड़ रहा है या कौन सा जहाज हमारी एयर स्पेस की तरफ आ रहा है। इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सिग्नेचर होता है हर जहाज का, हमारे पास उस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सिग्नेचर को मैच करता हुआ हमने उसको पाया, जिसकी वजह से हम ये कह सकते हैं कि F-16 इस मिशन में शामिल थे। तो ये एविडेंस है कि और एक AMRAAM का जो पीस हमको मिला है यहां से वो। तीसरी बात, अगर आप मीडिया रिपोर्ट्स देखें पाकिस्तान की तरफ से भी, तो आप देखेंगे कि कुछ इंजन वगैरह के पीसेस हैं, कुछ एयरक्राफ्ट के कंपोनेंट्स हैं या कुछ ड्रॉप टैंक्स हैं जो वहां दिखाए गए हैं, वो MiG-21 के नहीं है, और भारतीय वायुसेना का सिर्फ एक जहाज मिसिंग है, वो एक MiG-21 है। तो इन सब चीजों को देखते हुए ये कंक्लूसिवली कहा जा सकता है कि F-16 को यूज किया गया।
और बालाकोट के मामले में, वहां पर जो हमने आतंकी अड्डों को नष्ट किया, उसको कैसे स्थापित करेंगे?
हमारे पास, मैंने जैसा कहा पहले, कि हमारे पास एविडेंस है कि जो हम करना चाहते थे, जो हम टारगेट को जितना डिस्ट्रॉय करना चाहते थे, जो इफेक्ट हमको चाहिए था, वो हमको इफेक्ट मिल गया। अब वो गवर्नमेंट के ऊपर है कि हायर लीडरशिप पे कि किस तरह, कब और कैसे वो एविडेंस देना है या नहीं देना।
राहुल सर, माय क्वेश्चन इज इफ यू कुड जस्ट टेल अस व्हाट वाज द पाकिस्तानी एयरफोर्स स्ट्राइक पैकेज लाइक एंड व्हाट वाज आवर स्ट्राइक पैकेज एंड व्हिच वर द अदर एरोप्लेन्स इन्वॉल्वड इन फाइटर्स इन्वॉल्वड इन द पाकिस्तानी स्ट्राइक्स।
See, there are various operational connotations to your questions. So, on the operational connotations part, I will not go into specific numbers and types and what happened and what did they do. However, suffice it to say that the Pakistani package comprised of F-16s and JF-17s and perhaps some Mirages. And we had scrambled MiG-21 Bisons, Su-30s and Mirage 2000. So that was the forces that we opposed.
So which Mirages were these, sir?
These were the upgraded Mirages.
No, the Pakistani Mirages, sir, 3, 5.
That I can't say.
Shreya.
Can I step forward? Yeah. Sir, good evening. Sir, I heard your cryptic statement, just trying to understand what you were saying. What are the forces saying in response to Pakistan sending back Wing Commander Abhinandan without any conditions? Are the forces grateful that it is a gracious gesture? And B, what else are you saying? Are you saying, okay, you're sending him back, but we don't trust you, so our guards are up? Because you're clearly saying there's no de-escalation on the border or as far as our airspace is concerned.
As far as the Indian Air Force is concerned, we are happy that our pilot, who had fallen across the line of control and was in the custody of Pakistan, is being released. We are extremely happy to have him back. We want to see him back. Once he reaches back, once he is handed over to us, we will then further make any more comments.
Do you see this as a goodwill gesture, sir?
We only see it as a gesture which is in consonance with all Geneva Conventions.
Sir, just a follow-up. When can we expect
Colonel Anand, just one last question. Nandita, you have the last question. Sir, when can we expect Abhinandan?
We are awaiting the evidence, so kindly cooperate.
Yes,
sir. What does our intelligence suggest? Because today, under international pressure, have they started taking any steps to dismantle the Jaish-e-Mohammed, or have they still not? What is our intelligence suggesting?
We can't share the intelligence with you, Nandita. Thank you. That will be all. That will be all now. We'll now be presenting the evidence. Thank you very much, sir. Yes. Just hold on. We are showing some. Yes. Please hold on. Please hold on. May I request the Air Force to kindly present the evidence? Yes, you can see Jyot, sir. Please step up. Please step up.
Sir, थोड़ा सा ऐसे.
Step up. Table लगा दो. ये पीछे का रास्ता खाली रखिए. साहब रोल साहब मुझे दो मिनट
बाद.
हाँ उसका जो आम्रम
Wait.
Sir, this is really.